Hey guys, welcome to another 3D clinic session here with Josh Bondock Young and my lovely wife In, live from CEPH 2010. It's beautiful Friday afternoon, and let's do a little something here before the sun actually sets. I've got my 89-inch slick here from 3D Hobby Shop with the new 1521 Castle 110 HV and 5955s all around for servos. Okay, so today let's go ahead and talk about snap to hover. It's a subject that everybody likes to potentially do and can be something kind of scary. Coming out! And then blast out.
So let's go ahead through the proper motion of snap to hover. Essentially, it's a deep snap done at 3D rates. If you catch it well, go ahead, bring it down low for a hover or a torque roll. And then after you're done with a little bit of that shenanigan, go ahead, blast out. Let's slow it way down here to see the proper input. Notice I'm at medium to low speed, coming down, and as I'm ready to snap, pitch the nose up a little bit, throttle up, and snap. Catch it early with throttle, and then once you stabilize it, go ahead, bring it down, either for hover, torque roll, or other shenanigans. Let's look at a couple of mistakes here to illustrate what needs to be done for a proper snap to hover. So repeating again in slow-mo. As you notice, I'm going a little bit too slow, but more importantly, I was already starting to be stalled as I'm performing the snap to hover. Consequently, I don't have enough energy to carry it, and I ended up too low. And again, I didn't catch it early enough here with the rudder, which necessitated this bailout. Here's yet another common mistake, holding your control input way too long, especially your rudder. But as you can see here, just recovering a little rolling harrier action, and it looks like you're semi-intentional about it. Slowing it way down, good speed. Notice the nose is, I pitched up slightly to give me a little more clearance. Snap. Notice how long I held this rudder. Way too long. Okay. You should be releasing the rudder about 3/4 way into the snap. Compare this to a proper entry. Notice how I have released the stick about 3/4 way into the snap. Released here and began searching for the hover position. Okay. Properly done, it will enable you to finish upright, so then you can start entering into either a hover or a torque roll. Let's go ahead and talk about a finer point here, mainly the balance between how much aileron versus how much elevator you're going to need to add. As you notice here in this first part, we'll go ahead and review it again on slow-mo. I added definitely more aileron. As you can see, the snap is not as deep, but you also recover faster, and when you're just starting, this is definitely the safer route to go. In this next sequence, as you can see, I added just a touch more elevator. As a result, the snap is more impressive, but it is riskier. If you add even more elevator, you had what almost looks like a very tight loop, and you do end up lower on the ground, so do be careful. On windier days, you're going to need to finish your snap more in an upright harrier position to prevent the aircraft from getting blown back by the wind. Also, if the thought of doing snap to hover on your giant scale scares you, consider one of the smaller aircraft like the 48-inch Velox VR-1 from 3D Hobby Shop or other comparable aircraft, as they will be kinder on your wallet and will survive nosedives a lot better than your giant scales would. So just remember, whether you're doing it on a 48-inch Velox VR1, or the 89-inch Slick, or the 103SC, or even the 119-inch Extra 330SE, fly low and have fun. Alright then, until next time.